So we need to teach them the right thing to go.
Yes.
Love your neighbor.
Yes.
As you love yourself.
Amen.
One of the greatest commandments is love. And I believe that's the remedy. That's the remedy to our problem here today.
Yes.
Love.
Yes.
That's why God told us to love.
Right.
Because if we love one another, we're not going to be so quick to tear them down and destroy them.
At the end of that weekend,
for the first time, Baltimore City have been able to record that Friday, that Saturday, and that Sunday, no one in the city of Baltimore was murdered. No one was murdered. 1999. It was not our call. Our call was to go and have a revival crusade. Over 1,000 folks gave their lives to Christ in different churches. 5 years later, I decided, because of the call from so many, prayers from so many, we would go back to Oriole Park in 1997. At that time, we had a young man by the name of Reverend Jamal Bryant and the Reverend Harley Carter Jr. Then Bishop Vashti McKenzie. We had Kurt Franklin at God's Property with Stomp. We invited Dottie Peoples. That weekend, limited to 2 days, 125,000 folks came over those 2 days. Morgan State University Choir performed. And on that weekend, yes, there was a homicide, but it was the lowest it had been since 1992. Over the years, I've been challenged to do it again. For whatever reason, I could never press forward with it. Now I happen to work for the second most powerful woman in communication, Dr. Kathy Hughes of Radio One. Amen. Dr. Kathy Hughes has always wanted to have an FM gospel station. She has the AM Spirit 1400, but she did not have a FM gospel station. Her spirit is always to give back. When we had our four stations of magic at WLB and Spirit 1400, 92Q and Magic, she started something back then called the Stone Soul Picnic in Drew Hill Park.
Yeah.
She did that because she wanted to make sure the community knew. At least on that day, all that we could do from Radio 1 was to give back. She put on all the people from all different entertainment teams and performed out of charge. She got the gospel station back in February. In May, she said, I tell you what, I want to do something, and I want to call it Unity in the Community. One Baltimore, Unity in the Community. She did that. She was also helpful to me in my 1997 crusade. She then decided, on the day of our gospel fest, right there in Drew Hill Park, 12 noon, she decided to go on stage, and she said, before anything else, I would like for you to pray with me on July the 25th, 2015, that on this day, we will not have one homicide in the city, no homicide at all. That Sunday morning, 26th, I got up, called the mayor's office. Mayor's people called me back. You know why? We had 3 shootings, but we did not have a homicide for the first time in our city since 1992. With those cases being what they have been for me, Ms. Hughes came on my air that Monday. She said, what we need to do is not do special occasions, but we need to call this city together. And I want you to ask those who are listening to come forth, ministers, from every ecumenical fashion. So for 16 weeks, we set aside that we would use our airwaves, combine Spirit 1400, combine WLB, and Praise 106.1. And for 16 weeks, we were going to offer for churches who wanted to come and join with us in a prayer vigil, thou shall not kill. And we started at Greater Harvest, and we were over at St. Martin's, we were over at Christ Temple. We're here tonight, we're gonna be over at Emmanuel Baptist. We're gonna be down Cherry Hill a couple weeks. We're gonna be in a mosque at
Reverend Minister Carlos Muhammad. We're going to be in a Jewish synagogue. And all of a sudden, the doubters started talking about, don't do it. Beginning the Friday after this, the list of 16, now we have received over 40 requests of other churches who want to follow the lead of your master. All right. Yes, how are we going to do this? I said, we got three radio stations. So every Friday that there's going to be, we just want to simply let the public know. And I forgot this one we said, but I know the word pop up. We use that prayer pop up. And my goodness, Moses, I was just in panic. I was sitting there saying, this is all right.
Yeah.
I mean, yes, this is my fifth, but it's joyful to have people pray from their heart and to pray for this city. You think it's easy to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning, go to a radio station, and my producer gives me the news that I've got to tell you? Yesterday, a 10-year-old boy was shot.
Yes.
We still have a 3-year-old girl who was killed, and nobody wants to admit it. 3 weeks ago, I went to the funeral of 2 17-year-olds, cousins to each other, laying there in the casket next to each other. Families tore apart. And every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, I have to give the news. I would love to walk in there one morning and not have to tell the family, this happened, that happened. So, what we're gonna do, we're gonna finish out these 16 weeks. And then I'm gonna invite him to church, using our airwaves, every minister of faith-based leader to join us on December the 4th. We're going to have our Holy Ghost time. Yes. I'm going to be in the New Charlotte Baptist Church. Every minister will allow us to come into the church will be asked to be across our pulpit and to pray. We've already picked up choirs. People, I'm telling you, please mark the day down. Join us for the remaining 11 weeks, but at the same time, please note that we're going to have a culminating event December 4th at the New Charlotte Church from 6 to 8. It's going to be powerful. But now I'm happy to say, I've labored through this, and it really came from a lady who said to us at Christ Temple, she said, why are you going to wait till 2017? And I said, well, she said, you don't wait. This city needs another revival. So family, I want you to pray up that in 2016, we're going to go back, not the oil part, that's 45,000. We're going to MT Bank Stadium where the Ravens play, and we're going to put our people there, and we're going to let Baltimore know that our prayer warriors and our prayer commitment is so large. They think the Pope is going to come to Washington, pass Baltimore, after we show them what prayer warriors can do. The united effort of prayer.
That's right.
If I could ask Dr. Manning to join me, it's all right. I want to do something real special for her help. Dr. Manning?
Yes?
Can I tell you what? Sorry, you still have me. How many of you have thou shalt not kill